Hi, I'm Cheryl Wintermantle. I'm the middle and high school nurse. And I just wanted to give you some information about the equipment that we use here. We use these models of AEDs. And even if you're not certified in CPR, you can still be part of the solution when an emergency happens. So I just wanted to get you familiar with our AEDs and give you a few tips about them so you'll feel more comfortable with them. So this is a cardiac science AED. This is what we use here in our buildings and also in the elementary buildings. We have them in several places. We have them across from the theater in a cabinet that has a glass front. When you open it up, it does make an alarm sound, which just lets you know that it's being opened, which helps it be tamper-proof and also helps alert other people around you that you're getting the AED. We also have AEDs down in the hallway toward the pool, and we have one in the Gator Lobby on the mosaic tile wall. John Luce also has several floater AEDs that he keeps in his office. He sends them with the coaches to different sporting events. They also try to keep one out during sporting events here on campus, out in the snack shack or near it. Also down in the score shack, and they were also talking about putting them in the dugout. AED stands for Automated External Defibrillator. It is a power pack that uses pads. We also call them electrodes, and they go on the person's chest. They send electrical impulse from one pad through the heart to the other, which is called a biphasic shock. That way they can use a lower voltage of electricity. So they're a little safer. AEDs also, the pads also run like an EKG type of rhythm analysis through them. So the power pack knows when to shock and when not to shock. So one of the things that is important is to have good contact and also to get anything metal off the chest so that way it doesn't impede the electrical pattern at all. So we have different things on the AED. We have a zipper in the back, and in this zipper compartment we have an instruction book. It also has a cable where you can hook it to your computer if you have the program loaded up, and you can get a readout of everything that just happened with the event. And also there's a spare pair of pads in here if your first pair, if something happens to them or they don't work or they don't stick. In this small bag, this has everything that you need in case of an emergency. It has a rescue mask, so you can, if you're comfortable doing that, you can do rescue breaths. And it's got a reflux valve, so that way if the person is coughing up anything, you will be protected from that. A razor in case someone is super, super hairy and you need to get some of the hair off the chest. You have trauma shears if you need to cut the clothing off or anything that's in the way. And also we have a couple of pairs of gloves, and we also have paper towels because people can have cardiac events and get sweaty, or they can have a cardiac event when they're exercising or swimming in the pool and you need to dry the chest off before you put the pads on. So there's everything you need right there. Now, how to open the AED? You want to make sure that the AED, the actual letters, are facing up, because that's the way you open it up. There are two little snaps here. You pull them open and then it opens up so you can actually open up the actual power pack, and there's a white button that you just push. When you open up the power pack, there are pads inside and they're already connected. There are two different types of pads to use. We have pediatric pads and they're marked with children on them, or you can also see on the pads themselves it says pediatric, but it's kind of small, so you can look for this. All other pads are adult pads. They say adult pads on them, or they don't, at least don't say pediatric. These are for use for someone that's 8 years or younger or under 55 pounds. But if you don't have these, you can always use adult pads, just as long as they're not touching each other. If the child is small enough where their chest is too small to put the pads on without them overlapping, you can put them front and back. We do have pediatric pads down by the pool. But the other AEDs around the building are all adult pads. So another thing to notice is on the front of the AED, you can see it with the harness off or on, there's a green light. If you can't use the AED for some reason, if the battery is low or it's been used recently, this will be orange. So whenever you look at the AED, make sure you have the green light. Green means go. Okay, so we can kind of do like a little scene real quick just so you get the feel. Okay, we'll put this in a quick scenario so you can see the defibrillator as it would be used if you were in an emergency situation. When you see someone down or you see someone struggling, the first thing to do is as you're walking up to the scene or running up to the scene, you want to make sure that everything is safe. You want to make sure it's safe for you, because if I get hurt on my way to help somebody, then nobody is here to help that person. So you want to look for, you know, is there somebody with a weapon? Is there somebody that's going to hurt you? Is there a wire down? In, you know, any kind of danger for me, the rescuer. If there's not, I can come up and I can pat them on the shoulder. Are you okay? Can you open your eyes? Can you wake up? If they're not responsive, you can check for a pulse if you're comfortable. You can listen for their breathing. If they're not responsive, you can go ahead and put this on, because like I said, it's not gonna shock unless it needs to. So you wanna clear the clothing away. It's very important to get metal away, get jewelry away. If there's an underwire in a bra, you wanna cut that. And you can pull the shirt open. Don't worry about buttons. They can get a new shirt. Trauma shears will always work. If it's a t-shirt or something, they'll cut through anything. And then you wanna open the AED and place the pads. Once you open this up, it starts talking to you, so you don't have to worry about remembering what you should do. Here's what it looks like.
Stay calm. Follow these instructions.
You can see it's plugged
in. Make sure 911 is called now.
So a good point about this is you want to have somebody call 911 and you want to look at their eyes or use their name. Look them in the eyes, say, you with the red shirt, or, you know, you, Bob, whatever. Call 911. You can call from a cell phone, but if you call from a school phone, it actually sends messages out to administration. It sends them to my office, and it sends out for more help so people know exactly where you are and that 911 was called, so they can respond to you and come down and help you with the scene. If you call from a cell phone, nobody knows. But if the cell phone is the best thing to do, then use a cell phone. The pads come in a Mylar envelope that just rips right open. These pads are stuck front and back on the same card. Sometimes you'll see them on a foldable card, but it shows you a picture of exactly where they should be placed. And it doesn't matter which one goes where. Top right, bottom left, just like the picture shows. Make sure everything is cleared out of the way. Follow the prompts. It'll tell you to do CPR. You can do CPR if you want. If you absolutely can't, that's fine. Whenever it says analyzing, it will tell you hands off the patient. It's analyzing. That means don't touch it. Don't touch the person, because any like wiggling the wires or anything like that, you don't want it to get to pick that up. You want it to just analyze the patient's heart rhythm. And if it says it's shocking, get loud and say, stay back, stay back. Make sure nobody touches. And then it'll shock. And then I'll tell you to start CPR again. So you can start CPR if you want. If you don't want or you can't, that's fine. This is very important to do. So after help arrives and you have a chance to stand back, if you really, you know, if you want to do something else, get a piece of paper, get on your phone on notes and make notes of everything that you saw. What was going on whenever you first approached the scene? What were they doing? Were they lifting heavy weights? Were they running when they collapsed? Did you see them collapse? Was there anybody else around? Those notes can help them put together the picture of what happened to this person. And then you can get those to like emergency responders. If you can't get them to emergency responders, you can always bring them to other healthcare personnel and we can fax them over to the hospital for you. You also want to debrief. You want to get with your supervisor, talk to him about what happened, how you felt about it, what could have been better, what made it better. And, you know, we can help improve our emergency services. So this information I'm giving you here, I'm not certified to teach CPR or AED, but I have been certified myself and responded to several emergencies in and out of the hospital. So I just wanted to make you more familiar with the equipment and what you could do as an uncertified person to respond to an emergency situation. I encourage everybody to get CPR certified. If you're looking for a class, you can call me, you can call the main office. Jeannie Lippert can help you, or you can call the local fire department or the hospital. Thanks.